Hi friends, today we will discuss about the linear regression concept. So before going to linear regression, first we have to study the what is the regression analysis. So what is the regression analysis? So regression, it is the statistics. Regression in the statistics, it is the process of predicting the label. Process of predicting the label means process of finding the output variable. So label is nothing but the target variable. We used to refer the variable y. So regression analysis, it is the form of predicting the technique. The technique is the predictive modeling techniques which investigate the relationship. So this is the regression analysis. It has to find the relationship between the dependent variable y and independent variable x. So this is the data. In this data, regression analysis identify the relationship between this x and y. So regression analysis, it is an important tool for analyzing the data. So here we have to fit the curve or the line to the data points. This is the data points, means we have to take some values. So based on this data points, we have to differentiate the distance of the data points from the curve of the line. We have to minimize. So this is the point we have to discuss in next slides in detail. So this is the technique we have to use for finding the forecasting and finding the relationship between the variables. So between the variables is nothing but the between the independent and dependent variables. So what is the use of the regression? So regression analysis for predicting the relationship between the two or more features, x1, x2, x3, these are more input features. So what is the benefit of the using the regression analysis? Means one of the most important benefit is so significant relationship between the dependent variable and independent variables x, and it indicates the strength of the impact of multiple independent variables. So multiple independent variables x1, x2, x3, like that. So this is the indicate the strength of the impact of the multiple independent variables on the dependent variables. So dependent variables always, it can be depends upon the single input features or the multiple input features. So this is the benefits can help to the market researchers or the data analyst or the data scientist to eliminate the features and evaluate the best set of variables. So here variables is nothing but the input features. So target variable depends upon the input features. Among the input features, which features are most significant features depends upon the target variable. So these features we have to eliminate, or we have to evaluate the features by using the feature selection techniques. So what is the linear regression? So regression models are used to predict the continuous values. So what is the continuous values means? In previous class, in previous videos, I already discussed about the data types. Please go through these videos. So it is the supervised technique. So how can we use to call supervised techniques? Which means that this is the technique. It can be applied on the two kinds of data sets, either input variable and the dependent variables. So linear regression, it is a statistical analysis for predicting the values. Predicting the values means predicting the target variable. Target variable y, quantitative variable. So linear regression, it is one of the most fundamental algorithm in the machine learning techniques. In this technique, the dependent variable, target variable y, it is a continuous. So continuous values means the values should be not be repeatable. It means like that it is a age of the person and employee salary. So these are the undercome the continuous values and like that. So independent variables, it can be either continuous or the discrete. So discrete or continuous, already I discussed in previous videos. Please go through this video. So in this video I already explained this, what is the data types. So data types basically in a numerical data type and a continuous, qualitative data type and quantitative data type. Qualitative, quantitative, so what are the types of quantitative, what are the types of qualitative, I already discussed in the previous videos. Please go through these videos. So in this technique, the dependent variable is the y is the continuous, independent variable it any kind of data type, either continuous or discrete. So and the nature of the regression, it is a linear. So linear regression is establish the relationship between the dependent variable and the one or more independent variables by using the line. That line is the best fit line. It is also known as the regression line. So for example, this is the line, this is the independent variable, dependent variables. So data can be scattered like this. The model we have to the model is nothing but the line. That line is nothing but the best fit line. This line is also called a regression line. So building blocks of the linear regression model. So for building the model, linear regression model, so what are the things we have to need? So we have to need the independent variables. So we need the independent variables. The independent variables either can be continuous or the discrete kind of data types, and best fit line, best fit regression line, and the dependent variable. Dependent variable is the y. This is the independent variable x. So continuous dependent variable. So this is the continuous dependent variable. So a linear regression model predict the dependent variable y by using the regression line. This is the regression line based on the input variables, means these are the input variables. So what is the equation of the linear regression? So this is the equation of the linear regression. So m is nothing but the slope, and x is nothing but the input feature, b is nothing but the intercept, and e is nothing but the error term. So this is the equation. By using this equation, we have to predict the target variables. So what is the difference between simple in linear regressions? Basically two types: simple linear regression, multiple linear regressions. If you have only one input features, that is nothing but the simple linear regression. If we have more than one input features are existed, that is called the multiple linear regressions. So now we have to discuss about the simple linear regression. So simple linear regression, it is a method for predicting the quantitative response by using the single feature. So single feature means single input variable. So the mathematical equation of the simple linear regression is equal to mx plus b. So y is the response variable or the target variable. X is the input feature, m is the coefficients x or slope, m is the coefficient of the x, and it is also called the slope, and b is the intercept. So here the parameters m and b we used to call the parameters. By using the parameters, we have to identify the target variable. So for create the model, we must know the values of these coefficients. So without identifying the m and b values, we can't able to find the target variable. So once we have to identify the coefficient values, we can use this model to predict the target variable y. So now we have to go for mathematical part. Suppose I take the values of x variable, y variable. Values x values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Y values should be 2, 4, 5, 4, 5. So this is the our input feature. This is y is our the target variable. We have to calculate the x minus x bar, y minus y bar, x minus x bar whole square, x minus x bar into y minus y bar. So what is that? X bar means sigma I is equal to 1 to n xi by n. So means x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 total. So this is the x value, this is called the x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. So total number of variables 5. So x1 value 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 divided by 5. Total 15 by 5 is equal to 3. So x bar value 3, like similarly y bar value 4. So x minus means 1 minus x bar value 3, 1 minus 3 minus 2, like that, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. So similarly y minus y bar value 2, value y minus 2, y bar value 4, 2 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. So 0, 1, 0, 1. So x minus x bar whole square means minus 2 whole square, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4. So x minus x bar value minus 2, y minus y bar value minus 2. So multiplication, minus 2 is equal to 4. So minus 1 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 1 into 0, 0, 2 into 1, 2. So now we have to calculate the m value. So what is the m value formula? Sigma I is equal to 2n x minus x bar y minus y bar divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to n x minus x bar whole square. If we substitute these values, we will get the m value 0.6. If you draw this line, if you draw this graph, so this is the x value, this is y value. So x value is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Y value should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what are the our points? X value 1 comma 2. See, here x value 1, at the time of x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. So 1 comma 2. 1 comma 2. So this is the point. 1, 2, 2, 4. This is the 2, 4. And 3, 5. 3, 5, 4, 4. 4, 4. And 5, 5. So this is the data points. So in the data points, our x value, x bar value 3, y bar value 4. So x bar value means 3. Y bar value 4. So this is the 3 comma 4. So regression line, it is also called the best fit line. Y is equal to mxi plus b. So here m value 0.6. If you take the x value, x mean value 3, and b value we have to identify, y value 4 means. So this is the x mean value, this is the y mean value. So b value is equal to 2.2. So in the equation y period mx plus b, we find out the m value, b value, we know the x value, so we have to predict the target variable. Now we look into the mathematical coding part. So this is the mathematical part is completed. So we have to go for the coding part. here I am giving the file name. File name you have to give any name. So I am giving the demo. So first we have to import the some libraries. So what kind of libraries? Import numpy as np, import pandas as pd, import matplotlib.py plot as plt. So now libraries are successfully imported. Now we have to create the data frame. First import the data frame pd.read_csv our file name. So what is our file name? First we have to see the file name. So this is the data set we already discussed mathematically. X value 12345, Y value 24545, the file name is file1.csv. So now we can look into the data frame. So this is our data frame. Now we will see how the data is scattered. I'm copying the data time save purpose. So here you can see the data at value x value 1, y value 2, x value 2, y value 4, x value 3, y value 5, y value 4, y value, x value 4, y value 4, x value 5, y value 5. So this is the data, it can be scattered like this. Next we have to import the model. Import the libraries from sklearn.linear_model, import linear regression. Now it is successfully import the linear regression. Now we have to create the one object, that is object name, any name you have to give. I am giving the regression. So linear regression LR is equal to, we have to import the library, linear regression library. Now we have to train our data. LR.fitting means we have to train our data. DF, we have to give the independent variable x and dependent variable y. So now data is, the model is fitted on the training data set x and target variable y. Now we have to look into the parameter values. Parameter values means m value, b value. So lr.coef, coefficient. So coefficient means m value 0.6. this is the value we got already in mathematically, we calculate the 0.5 0.6. and lr.coefficient intercept b value 2.19. see, we got the value 0.6 and b value. So b value we got the 2.19999 in the coding part. So approximately this value is equal to 2.2. So 2.119 means approximately. Next, we have to predict the sum values. This is one object, biped, numpy array. We have to give some x value. We have to predict the values by using the model. The model name is LR dot by using the method predict and y underscore pred. So 4. So this is our y value. Now we can see mathematically y is equal to m x plus b. What is the m value? M value means 0.6. I can copy multiplication x value 3 plus b value. This is b value. If you give this value 3 in cell number 13, if you give the value in cell number 12, we are giving the input variable 3, we got the predicted value 4. So we got the mathematically got the value 3.99. If you see so here the blue line is the our model. Model is mean best fit line. So here the red dots are the our actual y values. So y this plus dots are there red color. So this is the our true values, and blue line is the our model predicted values. If I give the new data set, suppose I am taking the one more file, the file name is file 2. So this is the file 2. The file 2 contain only input variable, there is no target variable. So what we are going to do here means by using the our trained model, the model is already trained, the model is applied on this data set input variable. So we are going to predict the target variable, that is the y values. So how we are going to predict, let's see. So here pd dot read underscore csv, we have to read the file first, file file 2 dot csv. So we have to give any file name like df2. If you see df2, this is our data, sorry, you have to give the file name 2. So here, see, only our input feature is existed, there is no target variable. So what we are going to do here, we have to apply the model LR to the predict is a method on the df2. So these are the predicted values. So what we are going to do, PRED is equal to LR dot PREDICT df2. If you give the PREM means it will get the target variable. So now what we are going to do, we have to create the one new column df2 y underscore pre PREM. So means that here in the file, in this file too, only input feature is there. Now we have to by using the model, we have to get the y values. Already we got the values, we have to add this value to the this value in the file too. Now let's see, input this one. Now df2, so now before that df2 is only input feature existed. Now what I did, I applied the trained model on the df2, I got the target variable. So now what I am doing here, df2 dot to underscore CSV. So I'm going to create the new data frame. That name is, see, before going to this model, first I have to see what are the files are existed in my directory. So in my directory only file 1, file 2. So this is my directory. C colon users Prem Kumar desktop image processing examples experiments. How can you say the directory means current, present, working directory. So this is the directory. If you go to this directory, this is my directory, only two files are existed. So now I'm going to make the one more file. So df2 dot to underscore CSV. Here given any name, file 3. File 3 dot CSV. See, file 3 is created. In file 3, see, x variable is there, and we got the apply the model on x variable, we got the y values, and by default it came the some index values. We have to remove the inverse index is equal to real sc. So file name, new file is created. Let's see file 4. In file 4, see the values 0, index values are removed. So this is the coding part. I hope everyone will understand. So one second I repeated. So here import the library cell 1 and import the data set. This is my data set. And I can visualize the data set like this, how the data is scattered. And I here I am import the linear regression library. By using this library, so I have to fit my linear regression model on the x is the input variable and the target variable. And we got the model. This is our model. Here our model is applied in the coefficient. We got the sum m value and we got the b value. So if you give the input variable 3, we got this sum predicted value 4. So by programmatically we got the predicted value 4. So if you give mathematically, according to mathematically m value 0.6, we got the m value this thing. We already gone through the previous mathematical example. So in this example already you can see m value 0.6 and b value 2.19. So this is the values we got. So this is the values we are applied here. We got the values. After we have to how the data is scattered, how the plot is regression model. So blue line is our model and dots are the actual data points. So here we have to find the, this is the actual points and this is the predicted values. So between these values, this distance, this is called the error. So this error we have to be minimized by using the some algorithm that we have to discuss in next class. So here I'm taking the one more file. That file is only input features existed. By using the trained model applied on data set, we got the predicted values. So this is the way we are getting the linear regression model. I hope everybody will understand this concept. Thank you.